You are watching Work of Art on WHIG-TV, hosted by Beth Boykin of Framers Alley. Brought to you by Joiner's Funeral Home, serving our community for four generations, located on Raleigh Road, Wilson. Allen Winstead, Farm Bureau Insurance, Wilson. Call 230-1704. Will Ferris Attorney, Ferris and Ferris Law Firm, located on Nash Street, Wilson. Womble Real Estate, proudly serving our community since 1958, located at 602B Nash Street, Northeast Wilson. Call 291-1123. Framers Alley, custom framing, proud supporter of artists, Main Street, Elm City.
I'm Marion Clark Weathers. I'm originally from South Carolina, but I've lived in Rocky Mount since I was about 25 years old. So we just love the community here. When I first came to Rocky Mount, I worked as a graphic designer for a printing company here, Walker Ross Printers. And over the years, I have evolved into more of a painter. I've painted watercolors for 8 years. 1 year, we went to Wilson to the North Carolina Watercolor Society show. And I was so impressed with the work I saw there. I thought you had to be invited to be in that society. But all you got to do is send them $25 and you're a member, and then they help develop you as an artist through this wonderful community of artists across North Carolina. I think the process of painting non-traditionally is a way that I can show my individuality. I am very, very precise when I do my watercolors. And when I get into the oils, I give myself permission to be freer and wilder with that. And I think the creativity that Viola Simpson had inspires me to push it into directions I wish he could see my paintings. I am an artist and I love being able to be inspired by something that is, you know, right here in our community and yet known worldwide as well. Painting big is a different skill than painting small. It's much more difficult. And then the abstract qualities of it was yet a third step that I took. I went to the Whirligig Festival about 5 or 6 years ago. And the warehouse was open and they were bringing the whirligigs in and had the pieces and parts all around. And Joe Justice and all of the guys over there were just so enthusiastic about it and welcoming. And every time you'd go over there, you'd spend at least an hour talking with them. And I started taking photographs of the pieces and parts of the whirligigs and came home and started seeing the abstract elements behind them, and that is how this whole process of the whirligig paintings was born.
All right, my name is Joe Justice, and for the last 7 years, I've been part of the restoration team here at the Viola Simpson Restoration Site in Wilson, North Carolina. I get asked, "How did you get involved with the restoration?" It goes back a while. I grew up in New Bern, North Carolina, and I've always loved antiques and furniture, and I've got a lot of friends, and I used to help them restore antiques and furniture, and it's just something I love to do. It is something that is both intriguing, and I like to call myself an artisan, not an artist. Viola Simpson was an artist. I'm an artisan. I like to restore things, and what better project could someone be involved in than working on the Viola Simpson whirligigs? As I would work on whirligigs, we would often have people come into the shop, and probably in a 5-year period, we probably had well over 2,000 people from all over the United States, some people from all over the world. I've given tours to people from Australia, from France, from South Korea, Japan, Sweden even. And a lot of times they would be intrigued with what a whirligig actually was, and we would talk about it. And toward the end of, as we were slowing down here, people were asking me, well, where can I find a Viola Simpson whirligig? And they don't always come up for sale. So I had several folks ask me, well, can you make me a whirligig? And that's when I started building some small whirligigs. Some of those are behind me. I now have whirligigs in Texas, Massachusetts, Louisiana, South Carolina, and several around the state of North Carolina. I enjoy, because nothing says welcome to my home like a whirligig sitting in your yard that's turning. They're just fanciful, and they're whatever your imagination wants them to be. The interesting thing about Wallace's whirligigs, he would add reflectors, and that would kind of give a whole new life to the whirligigs. As the sun, particularly in the morning and late in the afternoon, is at a low angle, and the whirligigs were turning, then the reflectors would start popping, and they were just so amazing. So, like Wallace, my whirligigs have a tendency to say what my life has been. Growing up on the coast, and my whirligigs have a lot of things like ducks and boats and stuff like that, because that's who I am. And if you visit the whirligig park in Wilson, you'll see that looking at the whirligigs, you'll get to know Wallace from a different perspective. That's who he is. His art is reflected in who he is as a person. It's been quite rewarding, but the fun of it all is when they're in the wind and turning, and you get to see them, and you just kind of lose yourself in the whirligig.
Hi, I'm Beth Boykin, and welcome to Work of Art. Tonight we are honored to have Marion Clark Weathers and Joe Justice as our special guest. So welcome.
Good to be here.
Nice to have you guys. Just a little bit about Marion. I've known Marion for about 15 years, a little more, Marion. And Joe, you as well, several years. I've known Marion as an artist and cityscapes and things that you've done over the years. Admired your work and thought everything was just perfectly done. But now you've gone to a whole another level. And Joe, we've known you as an artisan, a restorer, a painter, musician. Yeah. So now you've taken it to another level.
Yeah, that's true.
So tonight we want to kind of find out how the two of you came together as this bond with the whirligig. So can you start, Marion, and maybe Joe can chime in and just tell us a little bit about it.
Well, you know, it's interesting how people from Rocky Mount and Wilson get together in the art community. I have been taking classes at Barton College in painting for a number of years, and have gotten to know a lot of the people there, plus going over to Beth's for framing forever. And while I was looking around Wilson, we went down to the Whirligig warehouse, and that's where I met Joe. I went in, and there were all of the whirligigs they were working on, and everybody there was so enthusiastic. Do you remember that day?
Oh, I do, but I also remember when we had gone home, everyone had left but myself, and I had closed the gate, and you pulled up and said that you were having a show of your art in downtown Wilson, and that you liked the whirligigs and wanted to see them. So I said, let's go look at them. We probably spent an hour together getting to know each other and looking at the whirligigs. And it's amazing to me. Her whirligigs, I can see her work, and I get a sort of a closeness. Having worked on the whirligigs, it just means that much more to be able to look at each piece and say, hey, I remember working on that piece.
And I think it's interesting how everyone who gets involved with Wallace Simpson's art get so enthusiastic about?
Well, it's hard not to work around an artist and not to be somewhat affected and become enthusiastic of. I don't call myself an artist. I call myself an artist, and I like working with my hands and doing things. Wallace was a tremendous artist, and I'm just thankful that I was able to help restore his work. Mm-hmm. That is, and if you're in Wilson, you need to go by there and see it.
So it's me. Do you think, Mr. Wallace? I met him. I knew him. He would come in the shop occasionally, and in fact, he gave us this little whirligig I got sitting here on the table. So, is a work of art all by itself. But Mr. Wallace, I think, would be so excited about what you all are doing.
Well, Wallace did come down to the shop. He would visit the shop as we were working, and he was very appreciative.
With Marion's work, don't you think the motion of her art, he would appreciate just the brightness, the art in motion?
I can almost see Wallace now when he looks at something that he knows represents him. Mm-hmm. It brings a big smile to his face.
Exactly.
He's quite a character.
He would have
loved to, I wish he could have seen her works, because they are a true representation of
exactly.
artists of his
exactly.
work.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Well, I think we've got a couple of things we want to show. Lee, do you mind bringing up just a few pieces right now, and we'll take a look and see what we have here? Well, I tell you what, while we're waiting for that, Marion, why don't you talk to us? Here we go. All right, there we go.
This piece is in the North Carolina Watercolor Society exhibition that will be at the Art Center in Rocky Mount through December 29th this year.
Oh, wow.
So it's one of 70 really nice watercolor paintings from all over North Carolina.
Okay. Now, that as a actual piece in the park, there's over 2,000 reflectors on that one piece, and it looks like Marion probably painted each one of them.
Okay. All right.
This is a jazz musician. I also have a series that I'm using that same abstract process, because they have the sound and the motion and the music that you see in the whirligigs, you also see in jazz music.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
This is a little abstract that I did. The actual piece that's in the park is only in green, but I got a little wild with this one and put all of the colors.
And
maybe next time Wallace would have done it this way.
Well, actually, that's probably closer to when you saw it and took the picture and painted it. Probably was
it
basically
was all green.
Green.
Yeah.
It was had a lot of moss on it. Had a lot of. Had a lot of years on it sitting in the park, and that's called reflector box, which there's hundreds of little boxes with reflectors on it, and they're pretty.
It's interesting to see how intricately everything is tied together. Now, this piece is in Paul Berry Park, and there are two pieces that I did as commissions for the family members of man that did the, well, Paul Berry, mm-hmm. that donated the whirligigs for that park.
For the park.
Oh, and this takes me back home.
Yeah, this was...
This is the Edisto River, mm-hmm. in South Carolina, where I grew up, and it's a part of my Rivers and Waterways series. And this is also another place at the park, the Riverwalk. And both of those pieces are going to be done as reproductions that are weatherproof, and
so they can be outside.
Yeah, so they can be outside.
Okay, well, that's nice.
This is near my studio.
Okay, that's nice.
This piece was one of the first times that I saw the abstract parts of. This is when I started seeing abstracts in Wallace's work.
And that's nice, Marion.
Oh, yeah. I did this in oil, and then there's a watercolor that these elements are also in. I love the way Wallace uses stars on things. You'll see that in a lot of his pieces. And of course, the duck. The day that we went there, there had been a big storm that had come through, and that duck was just flying around. And one of the things that I like about this was making the angry, busy clouds that were
that
also
duck,
a part of this.
That made the duck
that
fly.
That made that duck fly.
good ducking always follows bad weather.
Oh, gosh, okay.
And the bicycle man, we've got
yeah,
him.
Yeah, we're going to talk about him in just
yeah,
a moment.
Yeah. Oh, and the airplane. This is two different whirligigs, but I imagined how they would be put together by changing the elements and adding things to each other. This is a very small painting. It's great for a child's
mm-hmm.
room.
That's beautiful.
And as every time I went over there, I would see big boxes of propellers and things, and so I just started making compositions out of what I would see laying on the floor. This piece is the gear in the middle of a bicycle, and I saw it's really, really abstract compared to some of the others.
Okay. Oh, that's nice.
And then this is also part of my music series.
Right.
This is the series is called Thriving on a Riff, and this is an electric violin, which I was fascinated with. I've never seen one before. After you look at it for a while, you'll see there are two faces and several violins moving
oh
in
my.
The motion
how
of,
nice.
Of the
how
music
nice.
Going in and out of his head, and you know how people do when they play a violin.
Okay. All right. This is back to our little Wallace Simpson piece, and right now we'll take a break, and we'll see you on the other side of the break.
Okay.
You're watching Work of Art on WHIG-TV, hosted by Beth Boykin of Framers Alley. Brought to you by Joyner's Funeral Home, serving our community for four generations. Located on Raleigh Road, Wilson. Allen Winstead, Farm Bureau Insurance, Wilson. Call 230-1704. Will Ferris Attorney, Ferris & Ferris Law Firm. Located on Nash Street, Wilson. Womble Real Estate, proudly serving our community since 1958. Located at 602B Nash Street, Northeast Wilson. Call 291-1123. Framers Alley, custom framing, proud supporter of artists, Main Street, Elm City.
Welcome back. We're with Marion and Joe, and we're going to be talking about whirligigs and painting. So right now, if we can leave, we can just kind of shoot a little bit behind us. Marion, the one directly behind Joe, can you tell us just a little bit about that one?
Well, as you see, it's a bicycle man, but instead of just painting the whirligig the way he is, I take the different elements mm-hmm. of the close-up, like this is the other side of the whirligig, but much closer to give me more design elements and more, it's just more interesting to do the process, like, you know, to have more elements in it than what you just see.
Mm-hmm.
When I start painting something like this, I don't know where I'm going. I have to trust the process of how the design is going to work out.
Right.
And it's sort of like a meditation.
Now, is that one a for sale piece, or is that a piece that is in a show
well,
at the moment?
Actually, this is my favorite.
Oh, this
one.
Is your favorite. Okay, yes, and I understand a print may be coming from
and
this
so,
one.
And so I'm taking steps to have giclée prints made of them on canvas. And there are several advantages to having the prints, because they're weatherproof.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can hang them on a porch.
Right.
I
right.
have one of them hanging
how
on my porch
that?
Right now.
Uh-huh.
They're completely impervious to light.
To light.
And
okay.
all of that.
Well, how
and,
about
and
that?
And plus, they're only about 15% to 20% the cost
how about
of
that?
An original.
Well, that's
so
neat. And the piece
instead of spending $1,000, you're spending $200.
That's so. Right. Now, the piece directly behind you, is that a piece that also is for sale, or is that in a collection?
Yeah, this one is for sale, and What's the name of that piece, Joe? What's the whirligig?
That is part of the blue dome.
Blue dome.
Okay.
And you can see some of the blue here. One of my favorite parts of this is the star, because it reminds me of how one of my favorite songs, When You Wish Upon a Star.
Okay.
It makes no difference who you are.
That's right. And then the
piece. And your dreams can come true.
That's right. And then the one behind me, if you can.
Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. I remember when I did that piece. It was, that's actually Vallis number one. And I was just beginning to get the concept of doing whirligigs mm-hmm. as abstracts. And this is the close-up of just the very middle part of a bicycle wheel.
Right.
And it has all of the rust and the textures that you have, you know, before things are restored.
Well, talking about restoration.
It's kind of cool to see.
That is exactly right. Mm-hmm. Now, let's see, do we have some more pieces that we can bring up, Lee, and see a little bit about what's happening here.
Yeah.
Well, this one I did for Rocky and his wife. They live in Clayton, North Carolina.
Oh, okay.
They wanted one star on it because he's from Texas, so he didn't want all the North Carolina
stars. So this is a commission piece.
This is a commission piece.
I gotcha.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
This is a commission piece.
Well, that's nice.
This one actually belongs to Henry Walston, who is probably one of the most instrumental people in making sure that the Whirligig Park is in Wilson. He loves Mardi Gras, and everybody that was working there at the time, Sam and Mel, the mechanics, and a lady that would come in and help me and myself were involved in making that one.
Oh, that's nice. That's pretty colors. Okay.
This is a piece for a gentleman that lives in Louisiana. He is actually a gaffer for a TV program a lot of people watch. And he had a dog, and he wanted me to make him one. So I took a picture of his little dog and ended up on the whirligig, and that's in Louisiana.
Well, that's nice. Okay.
This is a tribute to the state of North Carolina.
Okay,
during
that's a nice piece.
Yeah. And first state flag.
That's right. And I think, is that the piece you donated, Joe?
I donated that piece, yes.
How mm-hmm. about that? And is that your workshop in the background?
Yeah, this is the restoration area down one block up from the Vallis and Whirligig Park. They've been very kind enough to allow me to use their facilities and shop.
How about that?
To do
now,
my
your workshop there. Looks a little different than Marion's, I'll have to say.
Well,
Marion's is a little neater.
Mine's a bit crowded. Vallis, it probably looks more like Vallis's workshop.
Right, right.
Vallis has so many things going on.
This is neat compared to Vallis's.
Yeah, well, you haven't seen all the pictures in our but in doing the whirligigs, we actually are over 100 different colors that Vallis had used. So they're pretty much scattered around on the shop. We use a DuPont Emron paint, which hopefully lasts 35, 40 years.
Yeah.
So the whirligigs we build and that I build and paint should last a while.
That's
outside.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite ones. It's just a cute color. I just like the colors. And taken from Vallis, you'll notice stars and then red, white, and
that's
blue
nice.
Ribbon in the back. Vallis was a very well-known, he was a great veteran of mm-hmm. World War II. Mm-hmm. And anyone visiting the park, they can actually see his life as he walked mm-hmm. around the park, growing up on the farm, and then as he went into the war, mm-hmm. and then his later years. So the park is... I feel like I know Vallis in a different way than a lot of folks, just mm-hmm. being part of that. Yeah, this is one that I actually gifted this to my granddaughter. She loves owls, and that's in South Carolina.
Okay.
That's just one of my little wind vanes. I do make little wind vanes too that don't have a propeller or something spinning.
Okay.
And that brings up an interesting point, the difference between a whirligig and a wind spinner.
What is the difference, Joe? Because I don't know.
A wind spinner is basically, if you remember the little, what do you call them, you run around with as kids.
Right.
You can make them in different sizes, mm-hmm. but they, wind spinners have to be approached by the wind from a certain direction or they won't turn. And whereas a whirligig You'll notice on Wallace's Whirligigs and everything, they have a tailpiece that when the wind hits it, it will turn the whirligig into the wind so that the other parts will function. So a wind spinner doesn't have that ability.
Well, I'll tell you what, we've got Lee, I don't know, okay, if you want to talk just a little bit, we have something here they have in their hands. Joe also is a musician, and how he and Marion kind of got together a little bit was playing the guitar.
I hadn't played my guitar for a while, and when I started working down here, like I mentioned earlier, it's hard to work around an artist and not be inspired.
Okay.
I would go home at night and produced an album through Music and More Studios called Wind Songs. And it can be found on windsongs.org.
Pull that up, Joe, and we'll take a look. That's kind of neat.
Yeah, the picture was actually taken in the shop, a local photographer.
Right.
It's my tribute to Vala Simpson and my work down at the shop. And it kind of follows the life of Vala Simpson from his early years into...
I'm remembering now, one of the times I was at the warehouse, you mentioned that you were composing songs about wind songs.
And
that's how I invited you to come play.
Exactly right. About 2 weeks after that conversation, I got a phone call, and Marion said, "Would you mind performing your songs at my art show?" And I said,
Then I had to practice.
How about that? So now, how can we purchase these?
Well, you can go to windsongs.org, or you can get in touch with me through the Vala Simpson Whirligig Park. And if you want a physical CD.
Because I have actually walked
Framer's Alley.
I've walked a brisk Christmas morning out in the Whirligig Park, and they do make music. You can hear all kinds of chimes, the wind and everything. So I know you would appreciate that. And besides an artist, Marion also has a book.
All artists do lots of things. We're interested in anything that has a potential to be.
So hold that up, Marion, and say this
is her. I have illustrated, the front is one of my paintings.
The Secret of Gum
and this
Swamp.
This is a book that I did. I did the illustrations inside. It's lots of illustrations inside this book.
And what age book is that, Marion?
This is, you can start reading it to your young children.
Right.
And then it's also designed to be for young readers.
Right, young
readers.
They're
just beginning that can read their own.
And
I bet they can get a copy.
And,
so where can we find a copy, Marion?
Amazon.com.
Okay. Oh, and over on the, just a little bit to Joe's, left over here, we have a picture of Joe working in the park, and that's kind of interesting.
Yeah. Actually, this was taken in the shop by a professional photographer that does photography for the Kohler Foundation, and he was kind enough, about a month after he left, I got a photograph, and I thought that was just very special.
Speaking of the Kohler Foundation, there's a twinkle in our eye that we have just begun working on an idea of taking our show outside of North Carolina to go to some of the other places.
That
would be a great
honor. Whirligigs are.
The whole idea is promote Wallace.
Restorer, and Marion is the painter and interpreter.
Okay. Well, I think the plans are in work for a collection of work to be traveling, and I can see this happening in the near future. So just a little bit on the I think Mr. Wallace would be extremely happy that this is happening, and I think his family as well, and we would love for you to continue what happens in the future.
So
it's kind of like saying thank you, Wallace,
for being part of our life and being part of the life of Wilson. So anyway, thank you for coming tonight and bringing your treasures. This is quite a beautiful set, and we appreciate it. And we would like to thank our sponsors for having all of the shows that we've had, especially tonight. We really appreciate you bringing them out. And thank you, Aunt and Lee. So we look forward to seeing you again next week.
are watching Work of Art on WHIG-TV, hosted by Beth Boykin of Framers Alley. Brought to you by Joyner's Funeral Home, serving our community for four generations. Located on Raleigh Road, Wilson. Allen Winstead, Farm Bureau Insurance, Wilson. Call 230-1704. Will Ferris Attorney, Ferris & Ferris Law Firm. Located on Nash Street, Wilson. Womble Real Estate, proudly serving our community since 1958. Located at 602B Nash Street, Northeast Wilson. Call 291-1123. Framers Alley, custom framing, proud supporter of artists, Main Street, Elm City.